So for those who actually innovate using the right technology to do better things, they will be the new breed of winners.
LSCM, which is the focus today, has done very, very well. It has raised its industry contribution percentage in the last 2 years by almost 50%.
We have seen the gradual increase in the import segment on cargo inflow into China in recent years. Hong Kong, as a world-class logistic hub connecting mainland China with the world, will definitely benefit from this growth engine of the world.
It's all about finding that challenge and solving that challenge using the best technology, the best people, put them in the right time and the right place to deliver quality projects.
Cargo traffic will grow to some 8.9 million a year, and the air traffic movement will grow to over 600,000.
With the vision, with the RFID and IoT applied in construction, we anticipate a safe, environmental, friendly, quality, and productive construction industry not long from now.
It's really about connecting things, everything in the world, and being able to be in control, controlling devices, controlling things, and then having these things report to you. So it really opens up a great new dimension for the internet.
This is what we are trying to do, is have a real-time locationing capability to show you where the person is.
If every one of us would move one inch further, we'll try one step harder, I think we still can do a lot of good.
今次我哋希望能夠將科技同埋物流嘅行業嘅專家咧，就埋一齊，大家可以分享一下啲共同有興趣又共同重要嘅話題。咁喺香港其實咧，就物流咧係一個好大嘅行業，將來香港物流咧係真係要靠科技咧，將我哋推到去新嘅一個層次。
呢個 seminar 嗰度咧係即係瞭解到好多最新喺呢個物流啦，同埋呢個supply chain management
嗰方面嘅應用。咁我覺得呢啲咧對於我哋個行業發展呢一方面嘅產品嘅業務咧係即係好大嘅幫助。我相信智能物流咧喺對建造業嚟講咧有多方面嘅幫助。我哋用嘅材料係非常之多。咁假若能夠我哋知道乜嘢材料用喺邊度？ 將來咧就算係喺呢個保養啊、維修啊等等都可以幫助到我哋嗰個行李處理系統咧，係用
RFID 啊，咁呢個即係對提高啲旅客個行李嗰啲管理咧個效率咧係有相當大嘅幫助。
透過今次嘅會議，大家知多啲，有個比較，咁希望政府能夠喺未來嘅日子咧係能夠增撥多啲嘅資源。 喺呢個資訊科技方面嚟協助我哋喺呢個資訊喺呢個物流業界嘅發展，咁希望大家可以繼續維護我哋香港喺呢方面領導嘅地位。